Hi Leos, welcome to my channel. We're doing your weekday reading, Monday to Thursday, August 14 to the 17th. This is you and the other person. Apply it to your situation, either or, okay? And then there's going to be an extended reading where we focus on the central issue and also the blockages of the other person. Okay, so here we go for you. Now, okay, I'm just going to greet all the Leos, happy birthday. Okay, I'm going to cut it short because I talk a lot in the previous one about Leos. Okay, I'll have a separate talk with the Leos, I guess. Alright, but let's just say that my relationships with the Leos are always, I think, the best. Okay, personal relationship with, okay, it's always been the best. Like, there's nothing that I can hate about the Leos. A lot of people, well, all signs hate each other, I think, at some point. But with the Leos, I think, good and bad, I think I appreciate you guys. Okay. Here we go for the Leos. You have here the Moon card. So, wow. You're having the eclipse. You're having the new moon in your chart, in your month. So this is the Moon card. So something will come up. So do watch out, because the Moon card is all about, yes, secrecy and this, you know, like all those stuff. But it's also transformative. So you might transform, or something that isn't the, who you're connecting with is gonna transform. Okay. Oh, yeah. That's what I felt right now. Because this is in the Monday to the 17th, which means the energy of the eclipse is coming. It's already there. It's you. Ace of Swords, yep, something is going to be revealed, which is the Truth card, Ace of Swords. Communication, if you weren't communicating or this person is not communicating with you before, they will communicate now and they will be honest with you. They will be straight up front with what they are thinking, not what they're feeling, but what they're thinking, okay? Because that's the Ace of Swords, is about their thoughts. So if you feel that there's secrecy, there's no more secrecy anymore. This is all honesty, all being out there in the open. Ace is always good. It's a beginning. It gives you that control of how you want it to go. And then, ooh, wow, Leos. You're gonna have either a new relationship coming your way. Okay, there's Ace of Cups over here. Can be with a water sign because you have the Moon card over there. This Ace of Cups comes in the moment that you least expected. During this energy of a cycle and the moon, I'm seeing here it can be in 18 days from that. Okay, interesting, very, very interesting. Okay, this Ace of Cups over here, this is a relationship offering towards you, or you know, to the other person. This is also seen like you're also trying to see the different kind of relationship. It's like you're gonna have an analogy. You're gonna have a looking inward yourself. It's like the different relationship that you have crossed path with. Okay. That's what I'm seeing. And then you have here, Nine of Cups. Damn, Leo. That's good. Ace with the Nine of Cups. This is Ten of Cups. This is emotional fulfillment, putting it together. Nine of Cups is over here. You're enjoying a time of your life right now. You're celebrating, indulging. Do be careful. This is, this can go to a festival, like, and then you just get drunk. But this Nine of Cups over here, something that you are wishing for, it comes towards you. That's why the Ace of Cups is here. That's why they say, wish granted. Now, when we say wish granted, I just want to tell you guys, it's not about, oh, I wish for $1 million. It comes like this. This Nine of Cups, when you say wish granted, something that you have desired, okay, is now coming towards your way. It doesn't go like bam. This is not like I'm a genie. Not at all. It doesn't work that way. Okay. So something that you have a desire, something that you have wanted, and that you have walked away from, you already walked away from past relationship here, and now it's coming because the healing already says past, okay? Let's see in the other person, who they are in their situation. Is this good energy? I'm seeing here also something might manifest over the fall, okay? So that's the time that I'm seeing also. So some people will manifest during fall season. Now, if your country doesn't have fall, just check what is in, you know, the fall time in the US. I think it's like, I don't know, October? Is that winter? Winter, spring, summer? Okay, I think, no, fall is coming soon. August, September, I think. Here's the other person. Other person, Four of Swords. Either they're patiently waiting, okay? Because the Four of Swords is also their healing. They dealt with some bullshit in their life, okay? They also know the danger that they're putting themselves into. Not that you're dangerous. They just know the risk of being in a commitment or being in a relationship. That's the Four of Swords. They're also trying to figure out things. That's one thing. And that's why they're waiting. When they are resting, meditating, contemplating in the Four of Swords, they basically, they can sleep with their eyes closed now. That's what they're doing. Like, they sense a feel of serenity, calmness in their life. Okay? Or this kind of connection. They feel calm. They feel calmness in this kind of connection that you guys have. Be careful, because there's a chance also that there might be conflict. I'm seeing. I know it's totally, you know, like all of a sudden it jumped. Because I see Four and Ace of Swords. So be careful about personal interests. Like something might come up. And then you have here, wow, Leos, this person has chosen you. You will choose them. The Lovers card, making a decision, yes. Twin flame, yes. Soulmate, yes. All those things that all the readers would say. But from what I'm seeing here, okay, is that they're waiting because they made a decision. They commit to the time. They commit to the energy that they need to be in here, in this kind of connection, because they know. That's it. They just know. Because the Lovers card is an energy that you cannot explain. So for them, it's just like, I'm gonna wait patiently for this Leo, and I'm gonna wait. I don't know why. I don't know what makes me wait, you know, this person, but they will. You see here. Ace of Wands, so much beginnings, Leo. This is like, if this is your birthday, stay in August. Do not move to September, okay? Chemistry, look at this. You guys probably had been intimate already, because this is the intimacy card, and emotions are there already. This Ace of Wands, it has been planted. Okay, the foundation is there. It can go to magnetic energy. Ace of Cups, it can go the same way. Okay, it's just like, this is the choice also. This is strong sex energy also. Okay, because the Lovers is also sex, and this is sex. So you guys have good chemistry in bed, amazing sexual energy. Communication wise, they're choosing some. You're being chosen. Okay, so it's almost like this person is putting where the king has to be placed or the queen has to be placed, which is the Leo. So they know it's not about being in a throne. This person knows that your heart is your throne. That's it. People think that Leos think that their throne is like being regal and royal. No. For me, when I see a Leo, their heart is their treasure. That's why they're the king and queen. You know, like, you know, because that's their prized possession. And you guys do that to yourself. You know, that's your prized possession. Makes you king and queen inside you. Okay, there we go. And then, wow, this is very long now for you guys. You have your Six of Pentacles. Reciprocity comes. Success comes also. When the Six of Pentacles is here, it's all about success. This person sees success in you, sees partnership in you. And Nine of Cups over here but it comes here. So there is success with what you wish also, or what you have always wanted. This can lead to a very, very good relationship. Now let me see the central issue for the Leos. Mm-hmm. Wow, you have your judgment comes. So there is not separation from the two of you, because this is a central issue. The separation here, from what I'm seeing, is that both come to the same page when they are ready. The judgment is timing. So you're getting your shit together, they're getting their shit together, the timing comes in the middle. Okay, I'm gonna explain later on what is divine timing, but this is divine timing. Okay, now in this as a central issue, something needs to be addressed. Meaning, if you have past exes, they have past exes, it has to be done, which I said you already walked away from it, and which I said they already dealt with it. Hence judgment comes, and then here comes divine timing. It happens when the universe wants, and it is the timing that they wanted. And from what I'm seeing, you know, because I said it's in the moon cycle, it comes this August. I don't put time and date, but this is a strong moon cycle that we're having. So during this eclipse, which is in the central issue, okay, this is it. Be ready, be prepared. Okay, so Leo, I'm gonna read more into the central issue over here and in their situation. The link is down there. Thank you very much, guys, for watching. Have a wonderful, wonderful weekday. I think you guys are gonna have an awesome day. I'll see you guys. Bye.